AI is going to be one of the most transformative technologies of the 21st century. We can already see how it's completely changing society here, now, and today.
Our large language model has several unique features. First, it's one of the largest open source models that have ever been developed. With its 70 billion parameters and trained on 15 trillion tokens, it's unrivaled in the category of open source models. And the model is also released with an extensive technical report that goes into great detail about the methods that we applied and the data that we used, such that this can be reproduced by others.
One of our goals of our LLM was to train on many more languages so that the resource would be useful to this global community of users that are underserved by the current LLM solutions. We've set the highest data compliance standards imaginable today in terms of how we respect author rights and how we filter for private information.
One particular technique that we developed and that we applied at this scale, which has never been done before, is also to prevent the memorization of training data. This is just one of several examples that we've done. And this is an important step to develop responsible models that are in line with the legal requirements that we have.
The second benefit, I think, is inspiration. Over the last few years, we heard this narrative that commercial LLM providers were light years ahead of anything that anybody else could create. What I hope we've shown here today is that that's not necessarily the case, and that this gap is far less wide than we had imagined, and that this LLM can be a starting point for inspiring others in Switzerland, Europe, and abroad as well to potentially get into this game and also design their own solutions that may, in the end, compete with these commercial providers in order to be a best solution for their own local environments.
The model definitely sometimes responds, especially during the development, with answers that are not well suited. And this is what the post-training phase is here for, to better tune the model towards what we think are appropriate responses. And we have done our absolute very best to figure out how we can train the model in a way such that it will be as useful and as harmless and as honest as possible. Well, our model is not going to be a replacement for the general purpose AI assistants that are already out there. For this, our model is too small, most likely. But it's going to be a very interesting platform for researchers and developers to build upon, and we are very much looking forward to see that happening all around the world.
This is really the first step with the release of this Apertus model. And not only are we going to be looking to the applications that are built by others on top of the model to drive the development of an AI innovation ecosystem, but we're also looking to continue to improve the model and this foundation in the years to come.